Even and I feel a little better also. Yeah.
So these are the pains that are big.
Pains, fatigue, insomnia.
Very bad fatigue.
All these things are
even
physical.
Even people with blood pressure.
Oh yes. Even chest pains. You feel like something else is happening, but it's just
this casualty a couple of times.
Yeah, yeah.
But can I ask you something?
Yeah.
When you're working, you know, like, you know, I'm 20, like I work at least for 7 to 8 hours. I'm so busy, I go for my walks, I'm doing socializing also, everything. But I'm always feeling fatigued and tired and my, you know, like muscle pain. So many things, you know.
We have a lot of causes for that, but we should make sure that we have taken care of all the medical things which are not likely to cause, and then we will come down to this. This is also a condition which can cause this kind of pains. So one should settle with that.
I think one myth a lot of people have is, agar main busy rahungi, to mujhe sochne ka time nahi milega. That doesn't happen, because your mind also operates subconsciously.
There's
a lot happening inside you as well. So keeping yourself busy 24/7, forcing activities down your throat even when you want to take a break is not the solution.
Yeah.
Addressing the problem is the solution. So that was the physical component of stress. Now emotional components, anyone?
You said something, no? Somebody said
crying, shouting, getting angry.
Yes. Anger, irritation.
Not only screaming at times, you choke.
Yes. Restlessness, you can't focus on things, all of this is happening. Mind related symptoms, anyone?
Not sleeping.
Can't concentrate, can't focus. What else?
Making wrong decisions.
Yeah.
Decision making is a huge problem. Poor judgment, whoever said making wrong decisions. Poor judgment, yeah. And finally, the last one, which is the behavioral symptoms. How do you behaviorally know that you're stressed? What happens to food when you see it, when you're stressed?
Eat too much. Or maybe you go to the washroom.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So unhealthy eating habits, alcohol use starts with stress, drug use starts with stress. Social withdrawal.
Kind of a nervous cough also some people have.
Constantly. And people nail bite. Have you seen people who are all the time nail biting? Fidgeting. They're always fidgeting.
Yeah. People who just move their legs.
So all these things are behavioral. So these are the big umbrella where different kinds of, and everybody will experience them very differently. Right? So now this brings us to our first activity. Vatsala will just distribute these papers. There are three columns in this if you see it.
Insan mein comes up in a different manner. So what happens to the body? So we said a few things that we do, but basically just keep remembering acute and chronic. So acute stress, there is a release of, let's say, lot of chemicals. These chemicals will step up your heart rate. People reach the hospitals with palpitations. They also feel they can't breathe. Because of constriction in the chest, like a throat, you know, that's why you can't take a breath. They also then get severe chest pains. So we have people who have reached emergency departments because of acute stress, they can't just face it. So it can be cardiac related, there can be severe headaches to the tune that you feel you're going to just pass out. And people think it's a brain damage. Then they can be passing out. We see a lot of people who will faint. And in fact, I have 100% of you girls I've seen who are fainting because of stress, and we don't know, they, all causes will come along. Because they just can't handle. And I think that's what she's saying, that exhaustion, with that moment, whatever happens. These are the acute things which happen. Chronic is actually really a disaster. So like she said, there's a good stress. So good stress may be out there, or short stress, let's say, there's a surge of these chemicals, then they go down. So if your heart rate was very fast, it went down, you come back to your baseline. Then you will feel calm or whatever you may feel. Chronic may those chemicals just remain high on a perpetual dose. So if your body has to have, like say, this kind of level, it's gone there. So what is this chemical which everybody understands is a steroid. So everybody knows So imagine it's like 100 times the steroid is extra in your body. It's going round and round. So what will it do? It will increase your appetite.
What you are talking about is something called positive visualization technique. This is in psychology. We use this a lot with clients. Imagine an athlete who's running an Olympic race. Okay, imagine the kind of pressure on him at that time. Matlab 100 crore log usko dekh rahe hain on the TV in front of, and his life depends on that race. It's a huge deal. Imagine if he thinks at that time ki main na ye race haar jaunga. Kya hoga uske saath?
Haarega.
He will lose.
Yes.
So the one thing that people always do in critical times is think positive.
Positive.
And it actually benefits. You visualize yourself winning that race. You visualize yourself completing this exam. You visualize yourself getting that job. It works. So every time as psychologists, as mental health professionals, we always tell people, don't imagine the worst. Imagine the best. Imagine hi kar rahe ho na. So imagine the best, what do you do? You know? There's nothing to lose.
Your stress will come up. So it has, like I said, it has so many hours in a day, so many things you may want to do. But you keep saying yes. You know, you don't have to say yes, but you take all the responsibility. So if I think that I can run a clinic, I can run the home, I can support you to garden, I can manage the staff, I can't. So either then I have to say I cannot do some things, I will do my energy into something. Because otherwise, you will put so much stress on yourself, and then your whole personality actually will start changing.
Yeah.
Actually, one thing we didn't talk, when we talked about the effect of stress, what we talked about, the personality changes.
Yeah.
So when you start feeling that you are changing, then you please start thinking that what is it that's making me change? And let me start saying no to all this and put my energy into something. So this no is half the problem, is that we are not able to figure out kya kare hain, kitna, so this
mana
is and this whole thing is
bura lagega, mana
kehte.
So that's another thing. Something that's really important, I think, which needs to be a take home message from here, is learn when to say no. Everyone has a threshold capacity. Kisi ki kam hoti hai, kisi ki zyada hoti hai. Recognize your own, and when you sense that things, like you were just giving an example about having four things to do, she learned that she couldn't handle the fourth one, so she went ahead and said no. Nobody else is going to appreciate your circumstance as much as you are going to appreciate it. You will know that I can't handle it. Just learn to say no. No is a complete sentence on its own. It doesn't need justifications. So learn to say it and be prepared to face a little flak for it.
It's fine. No thing is the biggest culprit, because then you are multitasking goes up to a very high end.
Absolutely.
And your multitasking will go
cathartic release. Finding social support in a friend, in a mental health professional, in a family member, really helpful. Okay, another thing just before we end, I want to point out is, when do you think you need to seek help? Because lots of people don't know. अब सबको stress होगा तो सब थोड़ी therapist के पास या psychiatrist या counselor के पास आएंगे. No, everybody handles their, they have their ways to handle. So when to know that this is the time that I need to do it. One, if it's leading, if it's become chronic, like we discussed. Two, if it's leading to a lot of interference with your daily activities, you're not able to get out of bed for days, you're feeling very low. That mood doesn't lift despite many changes in your environment. घर में शादी है आपको कोई interest नहीं है, कोई आ रहा है आपको कोई interest नहीं है. These kind of things start happening. ऐसा लगता था कि पहले तो I was able to pick myself up, but now it's not happening. That's the time you need to be very careful and immediately come and seek help from a counselor or a psychiatrist or a therapist, whoever. Also, if it affects your relationships to an extent where damage starts happening, family members ke beech mein problems hone lag jati hain, or you feel that, or I've tried all my methods, whatever I had I've tried, but it's not helping. That's when you need to come to a counselor. So this is how, all in all, you cope with stress. These are the four mantras, mediums, where you have to keep oscillating between all of them, like a pendulum, kabhi ek use kiya, kabhi dusra use kiya. the highest level to achieve is the acceptance, and the most result that you get is also from acceptance, because there are things that you can't change. Perspective change is important, but it works only till the time it is actually about perspective. The moment it's not